Hello students, welcome to the 12th video lecture of Electrostats. In last video lecture I left you people at the final expression of the magnitude of electric field intensity at a point on the equatorial line of a dipole arrangement. Now in this video lecture we will see the vector form of that electric field intensity. So let's see that. So this is the vector form. Vector EQ is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught P upon x square plus L square whole to the power 3 by 2 into minus I cap. This minus I cap shows that the electric field intensity due to a dipole, and you could see in the last video lecture also that according to the diagram when we took the component, only horizontal component was responsible for the electric field intensity on equatorial line. So from there we can observe that electric field intensity is opposite to the direction of dipole moment, so that's why minus I cap is written. In the same expression, if L is much less than Y, here should be X, so if L is much less than X, then EQ is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught P upon X cube or Y cube, whatever you want to take, X or Y, you can assume that one. Okay, you can see why it is like this. We have discussed in earlier videos that if L is much less than X or Y, whatever be the variable, then this will be neglected and square of X will be cancelled out with this 2, 1 by 2, so therefore only Q will be left out. The direction of electric field intensity at a point on the equatorial line due to a dipole is parallel and opposite to the direction of the dipole moment. Just now I have discussed the electric field intensity is parallel but opposite to the direction of P, that is dipole moment, which is directed from negative to positive charge. If the observation point is far away or when the dipole is very short, according to this particular case, then the electric field intensity at a point on the axial line is double the electric field intensity at a point on the equatorial line. On the axial line, when we derived the axial line case in the last video, we found the expression as 2p over here. So therefore, the axial line, when this condition is followed, the electric field intensity on axial line will double of this electric field intensity which we have calculated for the equatorial line. That same thing is written over here, EP is equal to EQ, double of EQ, sorry. So, electric field intensity on axial line is equal to twice of electric field intensity on the equatorial line, right? Next. Now, let's start the new topic. Actually, it's not new topic, it's subsequent topic of the dipole. Dipole arrangement only. Torque on an electric dipole in a uniform electric field. Suppose the dipole arrangement is placed in an uniform electric field, then how can we calculate the torque? So let's have the diagram. Let's have the dipole arrangement minus Q and plus Q charge. This is the dipole. The dipole length 2L, and now let's draw the right angle triangle with the help of this dipole arrangement. Okay, now this angle is theta, this is the direction of dipole moment, and this is the uniform electric. Right. So, why we have drawn this kind of right angle triangle over here, we will understand. Suppose this dipole is aligned at an angle theta in a uniform external electric field, then in that case, the force on positive charge of the dipole will be in the direction of electric field, okay, because electric field always goes away from the positive charge, so that's why it is in the direction of electric field. The electrostatic force on positive charge, and electrostatic force on negative charge will be in the direction of, it will be opposite to the direction of electric field, right? Attraction force and repulsion force, right? This particular force you can understand because understand by thinking the concept that this particular electric field has been generated from two plates where one plate is positively charged, another plate is negatively charged. So this side plate would be positively charged. Then only this kind of electric field, uniform electric field, will be generated. So this negative charge will attract towards the positive plate, and this will be repelled away from the positive plate. So that's why this kind of force direction is there. Okay, and this theta is the alignment of the dipole moment with the electric field. Okay, this QE is the force, F is equal to QE. This is also same magnitude of charge, so again force is QE. Now let's start. The force of magnitude QE act opposite to each other, and hence net force acting on the dipole due to external uniform electric field is zero. Net force will be zero because these forces are equal and opposite. Sorry, it's PE written, it would be QE over here. So net force will be zero. Why? Because these forces are equal and opposite, so there will be no translational motion of the dipole. So translational motion, equal and opposite forces are acting on the body, so body will not have translational motion. But if on a given body, I'm talking about the concept of system of particle, which we have studied in the last year, the chapter number 7, that if two forces are acting on the same body in opposite direction but having different lines of action, you can see this force having this line of action and this force is having this line of action, so they have different lines of action. So that's why if this kind of forces are acting on a given body, they will be responsible to rotate the body. It means they will produce which kind of motion on the body? Rotational motion. Okay, so for the rotational motion, which kind of forces are needed? Equal and opposite forces and with different lines of action. Again, I'm showing this is the line of action of the force acting on positive charge, and this is the line of action of the force on the of the force acting on which has negative charge. Okay, so which kind of motion would be there? Rotational motion. However, the forces are along different lines of action and constitute a couple, hence the dipole will rotate and experience the torque. Same thing just now I have discussed. So torque, what is the formula of torque? Torque formula is, if couple is acting on a body, then magnitude of either of the force in perpendicular distance between the lines of action of two forces. So what is the perpendicular distance between the lines of action? This is the line of action of this force, and this is the line of action of this force, force on negative charge, force on positive charge. So this distance will be the perpendicular distance between the lines of action of two forces, this distance, right? So let's find out this distance and magnitude of force. We are knowing QE, direction wise plus QA minus QE, but magnitude is same. So let's see. So torque is equal to QE, electrostatic force, into 2L sin theta. This value is 2L, this is theta, so therefore this will be what? 2L sin theta. So same thing is written over here. Now equal to 2QL into E sin theta, and 2L into Q is what? P. We have already understood. So therefore P sin theta. We can write this in the vector form. Why? Because it is in the form of AB sin theta. So torque is equal to vector P cross vector E according to the vector product. Okay. So this torque is a vector quantity. Direction of torque is perpendicular and into the plane containing P and E. So direction of this torque, which is acting on this dipole arrangement, according to the right hand rule, the direction of torque will be perpendicular and into the plane. Okay, inward direction. SI unit of torque is Newton meter, which we have already studied in the last class. this is the electric field direction, this is the P direction, dipole moment, this is theta. Okay, so this will be the direction of torque. This is a plane figure, so you have to understand that this torque is acting into the plane, right? That's why dotted line is shown over here. Clear? Now let's discuss the cases, because theta is here, so cases will be generated. So first case we are going to discuss, if theta is equal to 0 degree, then torque is equal to 0, because sine theta sine 0 is equal to 0, so therefore no torque. It means if dipole moment is in the direction of electric field, no torque will be generated. Okay, when direction, why direction of why theta is equal to 0, why if theta is equal to 0, then P and E are in the of the same direction, in the same direction, because this dipole will align in the direction of electric field, and this P will be acting in the direction of electric field. In that case, theta will be equal to 0. Second case, if theta is equal to 90 degree, if dipole is aligned like this, definitely P will be in this direction and E is in this direction. So therefore, theta is equal to 90 and sine 90 is equal to 1. So that's why tau is equal to P, which is the maximum value of torque. Right? Case third, if theta is equal to 180 degree, if this dipole moment is anti-parallel, if theta is equal to 0, then dipole electric dipole moment will be parallel to the electric field, and if theta is equal to 180 degree, then electric dipole moment will be anti-parallel to the electric field in this direction. Okay, P will be in this direction, E will be in this direction, then theta is equal to how much? 180 degree. And in this, that case, no torque will be generated on the dipole arrangement. Okay, because sine 80 value is equal to 0. So hopefully it's clear. So we have studied a very important topic in this video lecture, that torque on an electric dipole in a uniform electric, right? So this is the final discussion of current video lecture. We'll meet again with another subsequent topic of dipole arrangement in the next video session. Till that time, keep on studying, keep on working hard. That's all. Thank you so much.